Welcome back to Frog Detective, the Haunted Island. Woo! Still sick. Okay, hello. Why are you in the water? Hi!
Howdy.
What are you doing in there?
Swimming.
But there's a storm. Hey, it's not raining yet. Besides, it's not actually that unsafe to swim in storms. Everyone keeps telling me to get out of the sea. But it's safer in here than it is up there. Why is that?
No ghosts in the water.
Ghosts can't swim. How do you know?
Martin said.
You don't look that happy in there. I guess I'm not. Sorry to hear it.
Thanks.
May I ask why you're so sad?
Well, it's kind of silly. I really want a magnet.
Oh, I have one. Sweet.
I told you it's silly.
Why do you want a magnet?
Well,
go on.
My dream is to attach a magnet to a boat and hold on.
Oh, why?
Boats are fast. I'm not. If I hold on to the magnet, I'll be really fast too.
Nice.
Right?
I don't have any idea where to find one though, and even if I did, there's no way I'm getting out of here, not until the ghost is found.
That's interesting.
Is there anything else you need to know about?
Here. I have a magnet.
I brought you a magnet.
What?
Like, a real one? Are you for real?
Yeah.
This is a dream come true. Thank you so much.
No problem.
In return, I give you this big shell, which we can give to the duck. Or the magnifying glass. And then we give the magnifying glass to the guy next to Larry.
Wow, a real magnet.
Okay, so now we have a shell. Oh, I wonder if we give the guy the shell, we will get pasta. Oh wait, I need to ask you about the ghost.
The ghost.
What can you tell me about the ghost?
Well, not much, I guess. I heard noises coming from the holes around the island.
And they freaked me out so badly, I grabbed my floaty and got in here.
How long have you been in the water?
Maybe 2 weeks?
Your feet are gonna be like prunes.
Whoa! Your feet wrinkly?
Ew, I don't know.
You should check.
Maybe later. Is there anything else you need to know?
No.
Okay.
Okay, so... So you're Bernie, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Magnifying.
No, wait. Ah. I'll come back to you in a second. Wait, there's a hole somewhere?
Oh, that hole.
Are you? I can't go any further down. Okay. Out of the shell. Let's actually talk to the owner of this place.
What?
Who are you? I didn't mean to startle you. I'm the frog detective here from the agency.
Oh, okay. Just sneaking on me like that. It was very visible from the entire approach.
Well, fine. I guess you just don't look so spooky.
Okay, I'll do my best.
Sorry I'm so cranky. I haven't slept in over 2 weeks. I'm Martin, king of this island.
You're a king?
Well, when I got here, there's nobody else on the island except for me and Finley. So I thought it was fine to declare myself king.
Finley?
I don't think Finley cares about that sort of stuff. Finley mostly cares about Dan's competitions. No, I meant ask who's Finley.
Oh, okay then. Who's Finley?
Dance competition? It's tomorrow. Anything else? Best answer wins.
Okay. Who's Finley?
Finley lives on Nuba Island, comes to visit every few days. Last time I saw Finley, she was talking about the song she wanted to dance. She wanted to dance to for the competition.
Her moves were pretty amazing, not like me. She probably win.
I haven't seen her in a while, but she's probably still prepping for the competition. It's tomorrow. Not that I'd be able to compete with this whole spooky situation.
He sighs.
Got a question? About the noises. What can you tell me about the noises and where they're coming from? I'm not exactly sure where they're coming from, but I know they're coming from a ghost.
How do you know for sure?
I have a book about ghosts. It's called The Ghost Guide for Foolproof Ways to Detect a Spirit. I read most of it. Anyway, the book says most ghosts can't be seen, and get this, I haven't seen a single ghost yet! The proof is all there. Got questions?
Your nerves.
You seem so super nervous. Is there anything I can do? It's just the ghost getting me down.
I haven't been able to sleep. I'm kind of annoyed, mainly because I love hearing stories about ghosts. I read all about them on cyberware.com. But now, I'm living one. I'm sure we'll get to the bottom of things. Bottom of the grave, more like it. What? That made more sense in my head. I guess I mean like we're probably dying before the mystery solved. That's dark. Dark? Just like the conclusion to this tale. Sorry if I'm being dramatic. You know, I'm a good detective, right? I solved every case I've taken on. Except in the mystery I've had to put a hat on. My head is a strange shape. It really is. Point is, you're safe. I'm gonna find the culprit. Best thing you can do is sit and relax. Everything will be fine. I don't feel fine. It's gonna be really hard to calm down. I understand ghosts are scary, but it might be not be a ghost. You really think it's not a ghost? I don't know for sure. Uh-oh. Let's try a visual exercise. What is a visualization exorcism? It's a thing where we pretend. Imagine you're on a beach surrounded by calm waves. You can feel the cool breeze on your face. The wave is slowly moving in and then out. It's a safe beach. What beach is it? This beach. This isn't a safe beach! There's a ghost! No, the ghost is on holiday. Oh, okay. Where is it? On a road trip. Cool. Can we visualize that we're on a road trip instead? That the ghost is on a road trip. Great point. Continue. Anyway, the waves are coming in and out slowly. There's nothing to worry about. No ghost around at all. The ghost is on a road trip. Yep. Nothing to fear. A nice sandy beach. Just me and the ocean. How do you feel? So relaxed. Great. Me too. Thanks so much, detective. That's okay. I want to give you something as a thanks. Perhaps a piece of my crown. Oh, okay. Got a chunk of gold. Okay, so now we just need a pasta and toothpaste. It's really heavy. It's made of pure gold. Why? I like gold. Okay. Not at the moment. No problem. Okay. Oh, hello. Okay, let's give you the shell. And then we talk to the mouse. Always asking questions. Ask me questions. Just be careful. Big shell. I have a big shell if you want it. What? How? It's a long story. Oh, in that case, I don't care. I hate stories. Okay. Anyway, I totally want the shell. Can I swap you for it? I had this magnifying glass to look at tiny shells. I won't need it now that I have this big shell. Cool. Thanks. You're still standing weird. I still am alert. Here's a magnifying glass. There. Weirdo. Okay. Magnifying glass. I have a spare magnifying glass if you're interested. Interested? Are you kidding me? There's very literally nothing I want more. Here you go. This is the best day of all my dreams coming true. Is there anything I can do for you to repay you? You need any help with your secret agent business? Again, not a secret agent. Fine, fine. I could give you my lunch. Ooh, what cooking? Pasta, as always. There's one thing I love, apart from the thrill of secrecy. It's pasta. Anyway, if I have a chance outside from the deliciousness of this magnifying glass. That's a weird way to say it. Whatever. Would you like the pasta? Yes, please. All yours. Okay. We have... Okay, all we need now is the toothpaste, which I'm guessing... We get toothpaste from the Fresh X who's over there. But he wants something to keep his mouth clean, which I'm guessing we get from the mouse, who has a weird blue beaker behind him. Okay, so your name is Mo. Hi.
Hello.
Are you okay?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Well, I have just never talked to a detective before. I have heard so many nice things about you. I don't want to be embarrassing. If I'm embarrassing, that'd be very bad.
You're not embarrassing.
That's very good news. But the conversation isn't over. There's still time. I have to be very careful.
Oh. Well, is it okay if I ask some questions?
You have some questions? Questions, yes.
Nervous. You seem very nervous. May I ask why?
Because of the detective thing I told you. I'm afraid of detectives? Maybe when I was a kid I had a bad dream about one. Something like that, I don't know. I'm sorry to hear about that dream. What? Oh, I didn't actually have a dream about that, so why are you afraid of me? Fine, you warned me down. Damn your extreme detective skills. I'm nervous because of Mystery Monkey. Mystery Monkey is a huge fan of your blogs. I don't want to make a fool of myself in front of you. I just think Mystery Monkey is super neat. Neat. And I don't want to be embarrassing in case I mess everything up. Oh. Well, is there anything I can do to help? There's a dance competition coming up tomorrow. I want to compete and show Mystery Monkey that I'm really good at dancing, but I don't know what style of dance would impress them. Could you ask Mystery Monkey and find out? I'll give you this mouthwash in return. Sure thing, I'll do my best. Questions, yes? Bottle. What's in the bottle next to you? That's my mouthwash. I'm happy to give it to you if you find out what dance Mystery Monkey likes. Okay. Nothing. Mystery Monkey, I have questions. Dance styles. Hey, so, you like dancing and, dance styles? I don't understand. I like dancing a lot, if that's what you're asking. Yeah, kind of. What type of dancing do you like the best? Well, I basically only have one move. Yeah, but, like, if you saw someone dancing in a scenario, which would still be like, this is such a great dance. What? I guess what I'm trying to ask is, what dance style do you like the best? Oh, I think breakdancing is neat. If I saw someone breakdancing, wow, I would be swooned. I wouldn't even go so far to say, if I saw someone breakdancing, I'd be so deeply impressed that I would want to hang out with them at all times forever. That's great. Sorry for such a strange question. Anyway, see you later. Bye. On a monkey fat? What? Oh, that's weird, but okay. I zoom in on you. Okay. You have some questions? Questions, yes? Dance styles. Hey, I talked to Mystery Monkey. Oh my gosh. Did you mention me? What did Mystery Monkey say? Does Mystery Monkey hate me? I'm so embarrassing. Didn't mention you. Yeah. Mystery Monkey likes breakdancing. Breakdancing? I think I could do that. I gotta start practicing now, though. Good luck. Thanks. Oh, here's the mouthwash before I forget. Cheers. Okay. Let's go to Fresh X and give him the mouthwash so he gives me the toothpaste. What in the world? That's weird. That's saying something. Here. Back for questions? Take it away, D-Tech. Mouthwash. I have some mouthwash for you. Amazing, thanks. Am I going to use your toothpaste? I almost forgot. Here you go, D-Tech. Okay, so we got Hustled Hard achievement. Nice. Let's make some dynamite. Let's see. Wow, you got everything? Yep. Amazing. Shall we make some dynamite? Yes. Let's do it. Nice. Okay, we got some dynamite and we can get to exploding, baby. Why'd you call me baby? Well, this is it. Yep. Time to blow this cave up. Larry, explosions are dangerous. Sorry. Time to carefully blow this cave up. Thanks. No worries. I'm nervous. Me too. And I'm not even coming into the cave. You're not? I don't like dark spaces. I'm a sunny boy, baby. I'm not a baby, sorry. Anyway, good luck. Look after yourself in there. Thanks, Larry. Let's do this! Oh, he throws it on my ear, really. Oh. Hey, look! It's a cave! Everywhere. Okay. Spooky, scary skeletons in the cave. And suddenly there's dancing music. Oh, hi! Who are you? Are you a ghost? What? I don't think so. Are you sure? Yep. That's great. You're not wrong. So, who are you? Finley! Who are you? The detective. Howdy. Wait a minute. Finley. I know that name. I'm pretty well known around local dance circles. That's not it. Oh, you're Martin's friend. Yeah. What are you doing down here? Practicing for the dance competition. It's tomorrow. How long have you been down here? Geez, like 2 weeks, I guess? I didn't even realize. Haha, wait. 2 weeks? Have you seen any ghosts around here? Nah. Just me down here. Does Martin know you're here? I don't think so. He never comes down here. Really? Why not? He thinks every dark space is haunted. He reads all those ghost books and thinks there's a ghost in every crevice. It's good for me, though. Perfect spot to train. You have been dancing for 2 weeks straight? Yeah. Aren't you tired? I mean, I take naps, and then these mushrooms are super nutritious. Gross. Mushrooms are gross. That's your opinion, detective. No, it's a fact. Okay. Yeah, mushrooms just taste like hot grass. Anyway, mine's been super spooked out because he's been hearing weird noises all over the island. Any idea when the noises could have been? I've been listening to my radio while dancing. The cave has a lot of holes. Sounds from your radio could easily travel up to the surface. I bet it's super warped, too. You know you've been trapped in here, right? The cave has been blocked off by rocks. Really? Yeah. That's so funny. You could have died. Then I'd actually be a ghost. I didn't even think of that. Yeah. Anyway, we should head back up to the island. Yep. Okay. Finley! Hi, Martin.
Hi.
Hey.
Hi.
What are you doing here? I was in the cave. You? What? How did you get in? It's been sealed up for weeks. 2 weeks, to be exact. Wait a minute. As it turns out, there was never a ghost. It was Finley in the cave all along. She was so wrapped up in practicing, she didn't notice the cave got caved in. The noises from her radio came up to the surface and sounded super spooky. But my ghost books, I was so sure it was the ghost. Nope, just me. It just goes to show you should never trust books. Always use the internet instead. Yeah. Books are, without exception, factually incorrect. Oh, God. Or inaccurate words. Yep. Hi there. Apologies for the interruption. I hope you're enjoying the game. I won't keep you for long. But like you, the detective, on most issues, there are contexts in which books can be very useful and informative. Important to check the validity of the author's sources, and to check books is up to date. The internet can also be a useful place to find information, but make sure you're getting your information from a trusted site. Thank you for your time. Enjoy the rest of the game. So anyways, as I was saying, books have no place in our society. Sure thing, that makes a lot of sense. Thank you for opening my eyes to the uselessness of books. You're very welcome. So just to be clear, you were practicing for the competition this whole time?
Yep.
I'm in to win it. I'm still not entirely sure where the dance competition evolves. Dance competition. Best dancer wins. Who else is competing? That's a good point. Just us, I guess. Don't forget Mole the Mouse.
Who?
One of the ghost scientists.
The what?
Don't worry about it. I think we need more entrants. I know a few hardworking friends who could use a good boogie, but they won't be here tomorrow. Well, let's move the competition to today.
Yeah! Yeah! Woo! Fun!
Before we dance, I just want to say thanks for solving the mystery, Detective.
No problem at all.
I had a lot of help. Larry figured out where the noises were coming from.
Larry? Is that the lobster? The one who talks over everybody?
Yep. Well, I give my thanks to Larry too. So shall we boogie?
Let's go!
A game by Grace. Programming by Thomas. Soundtrack by Dan. Thank you for playing. They got all those dance moves. Thanks to thanks to these people. More thanks to these people. Larry, sounds from addition of music. Okay, I think we practiced enough. Wait a minute, who's judging?
I'll do it.
I feel like I'm back at like a school dance. I wish everybody's crowding around that one person in the middle. I'm still getting hokey pokey vibes. Dancing as they're gonna be. That's like a solid 3 minutes of dancing. Pick the winner! Ooh, oh no! Oh no! Who do I pick as the winner? Who do I pick as the winner? Let's pick Mo. Bye, Mo! Bye, guys! Still more after all this. What the heck? A little bit later. Oh, cool. So now this is the first in the game, so where does this come from? Oh, okay, our phone's ringing again. Frog Detective, Crime Solving Agency, Frog Detective speaking. How may I help you?
Detective!
Supervisor!
Great work on the Haunted Island mystery.
Thank you, I tried really hard. I don't think even Lobster Cop Search could have solved that one.
I think you're underestimating Lobster Cop. You're probably right. Anyway, I saw you busted a groove at the dance competition.
Yeah, where'd you see that?
It was on TV. Every channel.
Every channel? In HD!
Cool! I didn't even see any cameras.
Well, it certainly impressed the public. My phone has been ringing off the hook.
Mostly the calls about your dancing. But I did get one call about a case.
Have you ever heard of the Warlock Woods?
I haven't.
Well, there's something very strange going on there. They need our best investigator on the job.
Lobster Cop wasn't available?
Nah.
Can you handle another case, detective?
I can handle anything.
The detective will return in the case of the invisible wizard.
Objective.net.
Not sponsored. Okay. I hope that's the end. Because we're about 6 minutes over.
It is! Woo! Okay, so that was Frog Detective, The Haunted Island. If you guys want to play the game for yourself, it'll be in the description, along with the website, frogdetective.net. Also with my links of Patreon, Twitch, Twitter, merch stores, all that fun jazz. If you like it, hit the like button. You want to see more of my content, hit the subscribe button. Want to see get notified, hit the notification bell. Being 6 seconds and my words are scrambled like my brain. God, words are hard right now. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.